The heart of a shader is the actual shader program it runs. This program is passed to the GPU as a string of characters. I'll repeat that since it's a bit unusual. Instead of sending compiled code or binary data or some other processed information to the driver, you actually send it a string of characters. WebGL shaders are written in GLSLES, the OpenGL shading language for embedded systems. No one calls it GLSLES. Everyone simply says GLSL. If you use DirectX, you'd use HLSL, their high-level shading language. In either case, the character string is what gets sent to the graphics driver. The graphics driver compiles these into assembly instructions that are sent to the GPU. Here's how to create a shader string in JavaScript. The first line is how JavaScript says it's going to define an array. What we're doing here is defining a string for each line of our program. That's one way to get shader programs into 3JS, but it's usually not the most convenient. There are all these quote marks and commas, which are visually confusing and a pain to add and maintain. That said, one advantage of this approach is that you can glue together strings on the fly to make shaders. This is in fact exactly what 3JS does. When you ask for three lights and a shiny material, it creates a custom shader for exactly those elements. If you have a specific fixed shader in mind, an easier way is to make your program a separate text resource. I won't work through the mechanics here, this isn't really a web programming class, but see the code in this course's GitHub repository for how we do it. Basically, you create a separate text file or script element that has your program's text in it.